Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh, dear brothers and sisters, and welcome to our new episode about prayers in-house. Today we're going to talk about Eid prayer and how to perform it in-house. Because of the lockdown measures and quarantine because of the COVID-19 that we are passing through this year, most of the Muslims, they will not be able to perform the Eid prayer in the mosques. First of all, the Eid prayer is a Sunnah prayer, and it has to be confirmed. It has to be performed in outside, or in the masjid, in congregation, or sometimes it could be in the individual. So it both ways, it's acceptable to perform it in individual or in congregation. As we said, we cannot do or perform in most of the countries. We cannot perform this prayer in the mosques this year. So what we can do, we can pray this prayer in house with our families. How can we perform it? How can we perform the prayer? The prayer is only two rak'ahs, as you know. And the first rak'ah, we have to do seven takbiras plus the takbira of al-ihram, the opening takbira. So once you say Allahu Akbar, this is takbirat al-ihram. Then afterwards you say Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim, and so on. So this is how to perform the first rak'ah. It is seven takbiras plus the opening takbira, which is takbirat al-ihram, we call it. The second rak'ah, you will the transition takbira, when we go up from the prostration, the second prostration, to the next rak'ah, we will say Allahu Akbar. Then we'll stand here in the normal prayer, and then we will start to recite Surah Al-Fatiha. In the second rak'ah of Salat Al-Eid, we will not do that. We will do the transition takbira. We will go up from the second takbira, from the second prostration. Then when we say like this, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim, and so on. So this is the second takbira. So the first takbira is seven rak'ahs plus the takbirat al-ihram. The second rak'ah is takbirat of transition, the transition takbira plus five takbiras. Then the other thing, the rest of the prayer is the normal prayer that we know. So this is how to perform the prayer. If you are you want to perform this prayer in congregation with your family or anyone else who are living with you in the same house, maybe you are sharing the accommodation with your colleagues or workmates or something like that, you can perform the prayer according to the details I have explained here in this link before in our previous video, how to perform the congregational or tarawih prayer in the house with the family. This is the same details or the same positions of the prayer, how the imam stand and where he stands, where the females and males should stand behind him or on his both sides. They should be flanked or on both sides or the right side, and so on and so forth. Salatul Eid, it can be performed, as we said, in the house. And if you are alone, you can pray the Salatul Eid. It is acceptable alone. There is no, most of the scholars said that there is no khutbah, there is no speech for Salatul Eid. It is only when it should be performed in the masjid, there is khutbah. But in the masjid, in the house, there is no khutbah. There will no speech. There will be no speech in this one. However, Al-Shafi'i opinion, they say that you can do khutbah al-Eid after the prayer, just like you are doing this in the mosque, and it is two short khutbahs, just like in the khutbah that we all know, just like the Jum'ah khutbah, but it's shorter than that, and just like we all know from our previous prayers in Eid. This is all the information that I wanted to convey to you regarding the Salatul Eid for this year. Inshallah, and may be safe, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala heal all the humans from this disease. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.